went to the drive-in.
Welcome back to the fourth installment of our Halloween special, The Ghost of Frankenstein.
Here we go with part four. 1 through 3 was pretty good, so 4 has to be good, right? Released on March 13, 1942, not too long after America began the Second World War in December of 41. This is directed by Erie C. Kenton. Starting off, we got a spooky-looking forest in the background there of our title. Looks an awfully lot like the one from The Wolfman, though. Maybe that's because this time Lon Chaney is playing the monster. Yeah, no Boris, unfortunately. Bela Lugosi is back as Igor. We pick up just after Wolf and his family left the castle. The village is done with the monsters this time. They want the castle destroyed.
Destroy the castle!
Hey, look, it's Dwight Frye. He's back. And that's exactly what they do. They blow up the castle. Igor is still alive somehow. He's able to escape, and on his way out, he finds his buddy, the monster, who fell in the sulfur pit at the end of the last movie. He needs some fixing, though, so they head to find the second son of Frankenstein. This time, the son of Frankenstein, his name is Ludwig, and he's played by Cedric Hardwicke. He's a psychologist slash brain surgeon, and this is his colleague, Dr. Boman, played by Lionel Atwell. Glad to have him back. Unfortunately, though, he's kind of our bad guy in this one. He's Ludwig's mentor. In this situation, it seems like the student surpassed the teacher. Something with one of his experiments went wrong, and that's why Frank is actually number one and not him. The monster and Igor stroll into town and, well, get in trouble right away. All he was doing was helping the girl get her ball down after that kid kicked it up there. He's a nice guy. Well, the town doesn't see it that way. This is Eric, played by Ralph Bellamy. Remember him from The Wolfman?
Wolf? Gypsy woman? Murder? What is this?
And this is Elsa Frankenstein, played by Everly Atkins, who was also in The Wolfman.
Yes, I'm afraid I do.
So now we have 4 people from last year's Halloween special, because Bella and Lon were also in The Wolfman, which was actually released on December 9th, 1941. So it actually came out not too long before this one. So it's like, hey, we're done shooting this movie. Everybody hop over here. We're going to start shooting this one. Eric has come to see Dr. Frankenstein about the monster that they captured in town. They think he's just a madman. The doctor says, sure, I'll come see him, but after I meet with old Igor. Igor blackmails Frankenstein, helping him fix the monster, because he tells him he'll tell the whole village the story of his family and this monster if he doesn't. So Frankenstein has to help him now, because he's got a good reputation with this village. While he's in town examining the monster, Elsa goes through his notes. She finds her grandfather's notes, Henry Frankenstein. And we get a quick backstory on what he did in case you didn't know already. Igor and the monster sneak into Frankenstein's lab, and the monster makes himself at home. But the good doctor was ready, and he gasses the beast. Frankenstein tells Boman that he needs his help to destroy the monster. He needs to reverse what his father did.
It was made limb by limb. Organ by organ. It must be unmade in the same way. Dissection? Bit by bit, piece by piece.
Bowman tells him he can't help him because the monster is technically alive, and that would be murder.
I cannot be part of your plan.
Frankenstein then gets a visit from his dead father, or something, a floating entity or something like that. Yeah, this animation effect doesn't look so good, kind of goofy. But he tells him that he alone can fix the monster. But he needs to give him a new brain first, because he put the brain of a murderer in there by mistake. So he decided he's going to switch the brain out with the guy with the monster killed when he first entered the lab. That was Dr. Kettering, by the way, was his name. Igor is not happy with what Frankenstein wants to do with switching the two brains, so he suggests using his brain. But Frankenstein says, no, that's okay, buddy, no thanks. Igor is a sly, cunning SOB. He somehow convinces Bowman to put his brain inside the monster's body. He cons Bowman by saying, hey, look, man, you'll be way more famous than Frankenstein and the leading scientist in your field. And like we said earlier, Bowman's a little jealous of Frankenstein that he's the number one guy, so he definitely wants to take that spot. So they pull this brain swap. It has to be done at the same exact time. Frankenstein works on the monster while he thinks Bowman is working on Kettering, but he's really pulling Igor's brain.
Better death than a life like this.
And this wouldn't be a Frankenstein movie without an angry mob. And they're heading right for Frankenstein's house. because they believe that he's got the monster in the basement and he's hiding him. Eric rides ahead and tries to get Frankenstein one more time to give up the monster. Frankenstein gives in and brings Eric to see what he's been up to, thinking he was showing him Kettering's brain inside the monster's body.
You are Dr. Kettering. I am not Dr. Kettering. I am Igor.
This is where the doctor realizes that Bohmer double-crossed him.
This is your work. Don't touch him, Frankenstein. He's my friend. Bohmer! Where are you?
Here I am. I can see you.
You didn't realize his blood is the same type as Kettering's, but not the same as Igor's. It will not feed the sensory nerves.
So Igor is pretty pissed that Boman didn't think about this beforehand, so he kills him. Going blind, the monster destroys the lab in his rage, and he burns the house down too. Nice house. The rubble topples on top of the monster, and he's buried underneath it. But unfortunately, so is the good doctor. Pretty sure his idea was thinking, if I don't live, well, no one can carry on this work anymore, and the monster will finally be destroyed. Elsa and Eric make it out okay. And the end. This one was a fairly strong entry in the Frankenstein series. Not the best one, but it's not bad either. The intro starts out really well, and the ending is pretty climactic, too. A little bit of a drag in the middle, but hey, it's okay. Lon Chaney does alright as the monster. He's no Boris Karloff, that's for sure. He's kind of more of a softer monster. Bella is great again as Igor, and how he corrupts Bohmer to get him to get his brain inside the monster. Lionel is also good as a bad guy this time, but he's always awesome. The whole cast is actually really great, to be honest. Cedric plays a very arrogant Frankenstein, but he's good at it. He almost seems like he fit the family. He's got a little bit of Basil, and he's got a little bit of Colin in him, so he's pretty good. The scenery in this one is mostly the basement lab, but it looks pretty cool a couple times. The plot, though, is solid. So what's my suggestion? Grab a pizza and some beers,
and check out The Ghost of Frankenstein.